has a family member that lives at Sunnycrest, and we're not gonna appoint him to the Sunnycrest Advisory Board. Are we serious?
Since the last meeting of this board where the chairman resigned, I've been contacted by people about expressing interest in this board.
It's been open for months that a man or a woman could have applied for this position, and we have somebody that is willing and is.
There'll still be another opening.
Has more experience than anybody else that's probably in this county to assess the situation and make valid recommendations and have good input, and we're not gonna appoint him for what reason? What good reason do we have to not put this man on this board at this time? Explain that to me, unless there's something political going on.
I believe that there's people who.
Not a valid argument, because it's been open and nobody's stuck their nose in. So don't tell me that it hasn't been, they haven't had an opportunity to apply to this board for several months. That is not a valid reason.
The reason I didn't second is I believe there's people that have more knowledge about healthcare institutions and nursing homes that are interested in this position.
I'm just curious, Jake, you have a good reason why you won't second this?
I mean, I would agree with Supervisor Baker related to, you know, having people have the opportunity to volunteer for these positions. And I think that would be.
It's bogus. It's truly a bogus answer, in my opinion.
We'll have time.
Okay. I guess we know where we're going now.
Number 10, personnel.